I've been updating my CCTV system, and one of the things I decided to buy was a door cam viewer. Basically, like the little spy windows that you get on the door, your front door, or whatever. These are miniature cameras that fit in the door in place of those, and you can run them into a CCTV system, or if you just want to see who's at the door remotely, you can plug them into a TV that's got AV input. And when I got the first one, I thought, give it a try, see what it looks like. And I had it here on the bench, and I thought, that's pretty good camera for what it is. And I decided to try it out one night on Hangout with my friends, and I just basically put a little clip, which is something like one of these pipe clips, on the side of my computer desk, clipped it in there, and my friends sort of commented how much better the picture was. And I thought, well, yeah, at the moment, yeah, before I was using a Sanyo camcorder, old tape deck version, and you probably saw in a recent video I took it apart and said I got a new camera. And yep, I've got a door camera as one of my Hangout cameras, and I was pretty impressed with it. But you know, it was in any case, it was an upgrade to the old camcorders, and it's only for Hangouts anyway, it's not really for videos. So I thought I'll get myself another one, because one of the things I do on Hangouts is we're talking about equipment sometimes, and I want to show something on the bench, so it's nice to have an overhead camera. So I had a second camcorder, can't remember what make that was, that I had that on the bench, so I had an overhead shot for what I was doing. And you might be sort of surprised to learn that you're actually watching me at the moment through one of the door cams, and the camcorder at the moment is pointed at the monitor I normally use. So if I switch over to the overhead cam, that's the sort of thing that I do. You know, I can move the camera around, and I've got a rotational thing on there, and I'll show you that in a bit, how I achieve that. The right sort of lighting on there, and that, I can sit there and talk about the components on the board if I wanted to. Not that I get into that sort of thing, but it's just an example. Not ultra clear for this thing, if you want to get really down into the detail, but for what I do, it's perfect for the job, and it's obviously a nice small camera. So I suppose the next thing to do is to show you exactly what the setup is. So just down here, that's there's two controls. This one usually stays on number one. That's the camera that is forward facing. This one is so I can select different cameras. I can go from overhead, front facing to overhead. I've got a facility I can look at my DVR. Yeah, if I'm on the Hangout, I can watch that on the little monitor. And then there's a position further around that I've got an external socket. So normally I would be using that. Yeah, if I was making a video and I wanted to use this monitor, I could plug into that. Or if I wanted to plug one of my newer camcorders into that to show the friends something else, that these little cameras are not able to reach easily. So that's the little door cam on the side of the monitor. That's the close monitor on the bottom line. Normally I've got the Hangout on the screen up above, but that points nicely at me. It's actually a wider view. Being a door cam, it's got a reasonable wide angle lens without being distorted. And I'm quite happy with the result. And as I say, it's just clipped on with a pipe clip. The overhead camera is that one. Again, that's clipped on with a pipe clip. In this case, I've clipped it onto the sort of back end of it, and this disc on the front is more of a handling thing, so I can actually rotate it. And when you put these door viewers in, there's a thread there which tightens it onto both sides of the door, and essentially I'm just using the thread as a sort of bearing to rotate it to give me an image that's upright, depending on where this camera is positioned. And with the recent upgrade in my desk lighting, which I featured a video on recently, I said I had angle poise lights originally. Well, I got to thinking, well, I might as well reuse the angle poise part for this camera. Run a new cable up inside. It was a bit of a job because the cable was really stuck in there. I had to use a long drill. Pull the cable through, and I've actually put a splice in there because I didn't want a lot of cable hanging out here, because these door cams come with a fair amount of cable with the two plugs on the end. So I've just spliced it into the cable I've run up the stem of the angle poise. And being in the angle poise, I can actually move it where I want it over the desk, and even sort of point it in other directions. And the disc, I've actually cut a notch in the side, which is basically that's upright. And if I'm going on the desk, it's usually in that sort of position, and then that gives it more of a the right way round view, if you like. These cameras are fairly cheap, something like about £14. I've got these for £14.93 or something like that. So I thought, that's a pretty decent price for a reasonable camera. And so I've now got two of them, and I should get a third one to eventually put in the door. But that's the way it goes when you test these things on the bench and get the results that I got. Sort of hard to miss the opportunity.